In this tutorial, I will be explaining how to create pixelated seamless patterns with Adobe Photoshop. We will talk about how to set up the canvas grid and rulers, defining patterns in Adobe Photoshop, saving selections and assigning patterns to channels. We will also explore how to reduce the number of colors used in a design in the indexed color mode.
Hit the File button, click New, and create a file small enough to fit on a screen,
like 50 by 50, so that we can clearly see the grid on the artwork. If you can't see the grid, use the shortcut Command and H, or from Menu, View, Show, and select Grid. First, we need to set up the ruler units to pixels. The goal is here to get an exact match between the ruler and the canvas grid system so that we can be able to paint each pixel more accurately. Go to Edit, scroll down to Preferences, and select the Units and Rulers tab. Change the rulers to pixels. You will notice the ruler on the canvas instantly changed. Go to Edit, scroll down to Preferences, and select the Guides, Grid and Slices tab. Here, find the grid section and change the grid to pixels. You can see how the artwork grid system changed. Now, set grid line every 1 pixel with subdivision 1. Hit OK, and from the Tools menu, select Zoom and Fit the Screen tab on the top of the canvas. Now from the Tools menu, select the Pencil tool, select the black color, set the diameter to 1 and hardness 100%. Paint a single square. Now we can see we have an exact match between the rulers and the canvas grid. Now we can start creating the textile weaving patterns that we are going to use for this tutorial. We will start with a plain weave pattern, which is one of the most common weave structure, and by far the simplest one. For the plain weave pattern, we need a 2x2 blank document. Click File, New, and create a 2x2 document with a white background. From the Tools menu, select Zoom and press Fit the Screen. Grab the Pencil tool, select the black color, and paint as shown. This is a seamless pattern in itself, and it is the smallest repeat of this plain weave structure. Now, Edit, Define Pattern, and rename as Plain Weave. Close this document now. Let's open another one for the second pattern, which is going to be a twill weave structure 4x4. From the Tools menu, Zoom and Fit Screen again. Grab the Pencil tool and select black color and paint as shown. This twill weave structure is also a seamless pattern in itself, and this is the smallest repeat of this twill pattern. Now, Edit, Define Pattern, and rename as Twill Wave. Close this document now. Let's open another one for the third pattern, which is going to be a sateen weave structure 5x5. Tools menu, Zoom, and Fit Screen. Grab the Pencil tool, select the black color, and paint as shown. This is an example of sateen weave structure. Now, Edit, Define Pattern, and rename as sateen weave. Now let's close all the documents. Now let's open a seamless floral design and try to apply the pixelated textile weaving patterns to the floral design. Now we have to take a break here and try to remember the greatest common divider in math. Each and every element in a seamless pattern must repeat itself. In our case, we have a seamless floral design with the dimensions 2000 pixels by 2000 pixels. And the patterns that we created, plain weave 2x2, twill weave 4x4, and sateen weave pattern is 5x5. The width and the height of the seamless floral design must be divided evenly by 4, 2, and 5. By other means, remainder upon division has to be 0. Change the image mode to index color. Click image mode and select index color. A small pop-up window will appear. Select the palette to local adaptive. Colors to 3, since we have already created 3 different textile weave patterns. Forced to none and the options to none. Hit OK. Again, image mode, and now select the color table. You can see here on the color table there are only 3 colors visible. These colors can be altered, combined, or other colors can be inserted here. But in this tutorial, we are only interested in these colors because they represent different areas on the seamless floral design. Click cancel. And now, we are going to save these different colored areas as selections. First, we need to change the color mode back to RGB, image, mode, select RGB color. And now, click select and color range. A pop-up window will appear. Set fuzziness to 0 and grab the eyedropper tool. Select the first color on the seamless floral design. Hit OK and you will see the selected portion of the design. Now select and save selection. On the save selection pop-up window, leave everything as it is. And name the new channel as color 1. Let's do the same for the other 2 colors. And now deselect the selection with the shortcut Ctrl D or from the select menu deselect. Now we are going to apply our pixelated textile weaving patterns to the recently saved channels. Click the select button and scroll down to load selection. A new load selection window will pop up. From the load selection window, go to the channel and select color 1. Hit OK. Now grab the paint bucket tool from the tools menu and change the foreground to pattern. Select the plain weave pattern and click anywhere in the selection area. Bear in mind that if the contiguous on the top of the canvas is selected, only some parts of the first color will be filled with the pattern. Make sure to uncheck this before applying the pattern to the selection. Let's do the same for other 2 colors. And now we have a pixelated textile weaving design. Hope you liked it. See you soon.